Flat Earth Clues Part 1, The Empty Theater. This is part of a series of clues that can help you get your head around both the design of the Flat Earth system we live in and who has been involved in the deception to hide it from you.
Crap, that sure is a mystery.
Yeah, it sounds super hard.
Thank you.
do we explain the movement of the sun across the sky and the equinox, solstices, seasons, and tides?
Got it. I'll lump it all up in one thing.
Okay.
Stars, planets, sun, moon. Okay, we'll break it in two sections real quick. Stars and the planets, they are projected. They are not there. They are a beautiful, beautiful image. You can look at them. I encourage people to go out and stare at the stars. They're great. The moon is being projected on. I do not know what the moon is, and a lot of people don't either. The sun appears to be a projection system of its own.
My clue's pointing over there now. Oh, let's follow that clue.
How far away? It could be, as far as I know, a light bulb in a cage. I hate to say it.
If the Earth is flat, then where does the heat come from?
Good one. You mean the heat from, most of the temperature is underneath. You know, you can control it. You know, it's all the temperature mechanisms are going to be below us. Yeah, the sun's going to give off some heat, obviously, but no more than, a big light bulb in a big light bulb in a big area, like a terrarium. You can do so much more below than you can above. So the short answer to that, as far as where does the heat come from, I think mostly below with the system. That's how I would do it.
Oh, that's giving me a clue. Yeah, I've got a raging clue right now.